They are also, if you're working on a sponsor miners, who do practice in the process in the country, maybe roughly around 4,000 sponsor miners are involved in the processing of minerals using traditional mineral processing technologies. And in this presentation, I'm just going to look at a few technologies, just traditional ones, that are used by artisanal small scale miners. And this includes the processing of wood gold into a second product, processing of limestone into casual lime, processing of sand soils into consumer domestic soils, and also clays into ceramic products. Coming to wood gold processing, just to mention that wood gold occurs in various parts of the country. And this has also been reported in the bullets that are produced by the side of magnets. Most of this gold, the gold exploitation is done illegally by artisanal small scale miners, particularly along the river banks and surrounding food areas. During the processing, what happens is that the small-scale miners, after they have extracted the auriferous sands, they place it in what I would call an improvised statistic Swiss box, which is made from iron metal, and it has perforations of the diameter of about 2 to 10 millimeters, and that actually, along the sides is supported by some parts of wood, as shown in the diagram. And then, even if this is Swiss box, it's placed in what is known as a perforated sack with some open spirals to capture the wood gold particles that pass through the perforation of this Swiss box. And then, this is shown in the diagram and figure 2. I see. After these gold particles have been collected along the evolved spirals, it is scraped off into some bucket or pan for washing in the rivers, as shown in the diagram. And then this is the washing is done to remove some particles, as well as organic matter, and then you get the fine gold particles, which are then dried and then placed in the back of the cell, as shown in the figure. Moving on quickly to processing the food, right from the two straight lime and agricultural lime. Just to mention that right from the one of the important minerals that are exploited by artisanal small scale miners in the country, and is used as I have said earlier, in the production of slate lime and agricultural lime, among other important uses. And we have in the country different several types of agricultural currencies, and most of the important currencies are the marble bands in the basement complex sizes. And some are lines from cars, carbonatized and cemented rocks. Turning to production of slate lime or hydrated lime, the process involves three main stages, and the first one is also preparation, and then burning or conversion or calcination, then hydration, which is also known as slaking. Turning to limestone preparation, it involves mining or burning and then sizing or screening. The mine, this limestone is using some balls, some picks, some jackhammers, some rollers, but those who are more financially able hire sometimes excavators and bulldozers to do mining for them. Now, after they have mined this limestone, what follows is a reduction of the size particle of this limestone. And actually, this is done using handheld hammers in preparation for conversion. Actually, the limestone is reduced to sizes of 50 millimeters to about 100 millimeters. Then, following this size reduction, which is also known as comminution, the limestone is bent, calcination process takes place. This is to get rid of the carbon dioxide from the limestone, which is the calcium carbonate, in order to obtain calcium oxide, which is quicklime. And the reaction is as shown, like in the case of acidic limestone, which is calcium carbonate, is heated to about, the temperature is about 1,300 degrees Celsius from calcium oxide and also, which is known as quicklime, as well as carbon dioxide, which is CO2. Turning to dolomitic limestone, it's a reaction to the calcium carbonate, but suffice to say that dolomitic limestone is a calcium magnesium carbonate type of rock. And it's heated to about, the temperature is about 900 to 1,500 degrees Celsius to form the quicklime, which is calcium magnesium oxide, and then carbon dioxide, CO2. And if you look carefully at the reaction, you will see that at least more heat is required to heat the calcium carbonate, which is acidic limestone, than the calcium magnesium carbonate. Maybe the calcium carbonate rock has got strong bonds that requires a lot of energy to actually break the bonds into those final products, calcium oxide and calcium at the outside. Yeah, there are two types of tools that are used. Those are objects that are used to actually gain this limestone. The first one is my titanium brush tool. This one is constructed in the ground. You see, actually, the granular is cheap in shape, but the size is fine, but on average, weighs about 6 meters by 4 meters and 2 meters. Normally, this granular flash kiln is walls are addressed by stone abutments. Just up at the base, we have constructed some trenches, and openings are also created along the short sides that connects to the trenches. And just above these trenches, we have constructed also some archery boards with large marble holders. And then, following this construction, limestone. All the layers of limestone and fuel mold packed in that kiln, and in terms of ratio, the amount of limestone about 75 tons of marble or limestone requires about 75 tons of fuel. And then the kiln is ignited and stocked for about 48 hours, and then thereafter. The fire boards are sealed and the kiln is left to burn for approximately 2 to 3 days. Following this, the main limestone is allowed to cool about 6 to 8 days before discharging for slaking. Here is a big chunk of the traditional batch kiln that are used by different small scale miners in our countries. Turning to metal kilns, these are modern kilns that are used by also artisan small scale miners in the country. They are slim in shape. They vary in size, of course, but on average they weigh about 7 meters high, maybe a diameter of 1 to 2 meters. Inside this kiln, there is a lining. It is constructed using a lining of different liquids, about 2 to 3 layers. And this is also followed by another 2 to 3 layers of ordinary beam bricks. And then a chimney is constructed on top of this kiln. And at the base, there are also openings, which we call the doors, which are used for loading maybe some initial fuel to initiate a conversion of the limestone. I really don't want to spend much time on that, but here is a picture of the petrol that is used, but some of the other elements is still in the limestone bearing. Following the discharge of limestone, out of the dead line, limestone, and then the limestone is a slag. Slagging involves adding water into the dead limestone with the speed line to form calcium hydroxide. The reaction is high, there is a lot of heat. And the reaction is progressive. But generally, as you add more and more equilibrium of the chemical reaction shifts to the right, that is to get more calcium hydroxide. Following the slagging, right from the slag line, which is calcium hydroxide, they undergo something using the hard punch metal sheet, see, in about 10 millimeters. Which preparation is about 10 millimeters. And following the sieving, thus remove and bend the limestone. And following the sieving, the limestone is melted using the hammer nails. And normally, it's fashion like the one that I use for me when I was in the country. And following the milling, the limestone is back, is back by hand, as it was said. Coming to the processing of limestone to that's right. The process is quite simple. You just have to mine the limestone, then you just crush it using the initial ingredient, the volumes, the nutrition meals, small particles, and then you mill it further, you grind it further using using the pulverizers or volumes. Suffice to say that I think the active ingredient in this agricultural is calcium carbonate. And it's used as one of the soil conditioners in farming. Quickly coming on to soil processing, we have also some superficial deposits in certain parts of the country. And this soil deposits, the salt is produced from the evaporates. That form in the rapidly evaporating low-lying areas, that form will become swamps during the dry season. And generally, these areas are overlain by silt and clay that comes from the surrounding hills. During the salt forming process, the salt rises to the topsoil layer through the action, capillary action of water, and this layer, about 2 to 5 centimeters, is scraped off from this topsoil layer for enriching or filtration method. And filtration is done in a crude filter. I will show you this in the edge, as shown. This cool filter is made from the woven starch, which is supported by four wooden poles. And sort of the script soil is pouring on top, and the water similarly poured on top. And then you play the screw the starch and get created at the bottom of the ridge. And then this ridge is further subjected to some purification process using aluminum sulfate, maybe about 3 to 4 grams of aluminum sulfate is used during this purification process, which involves the concretion of the colloids, aluminum and organic colloids, suspended in the ridge. And following this purification process, the salt is poured, the leachate is poured into and then you got after to initiate the crystallization process. Water is evaporating and salt forms as a deposit. Yes, it is scraped off ready for drying, and after drying, the salt is analyzed using potassium ions. Just about 7 to 30 milligrams of potassium ions is used for about 20 kilograms of salt. Naturally, the sterilization process is very manual using some equipment to discussion like a concrete mix in the construction process. And then during the ionization process, the salt is packed in the market. Coming to ceramic processing, using galvanic clay. Ceramics are generally defined as a class of organic and organic solid materials that are subject to high temperatures for manufacturing use. What happens generally is that after the galvanic clay is mined or extracted, it is subjected to a forming process which involves shaping this clay into some ceramic body. Following the shaping, then it's dried, and following drying, the ceramic product is fired in the high temperature oven, which is a kiln. Basically, there are two groups of ceramic production. This is probably two different categories: the traditional ceramics and also the technologically advanced ceramic production. And the traditional ceramics basically involves the production of tableware, pottery, such as the trays, the tables, the cups, and other decorations. On the other hand, the highly technologically advanced ceramic production involves production of some technical ceramics, chemical, mechanical, and general applications. In Malawi, some other responsible men are involved in production of ceramics, but mostly women. We have also a few companies that are involved in production of ceramics. We have one company in the central region known as Arab Ceramics. Here in the picture, you can write some of the ceramic products that are produced in the country. I mentioned earlier on some processes that are involved in production of the ceramics. First, the production of this traditional ceramics involves the union of the carbonated clay and the glazing material. The glazing material generally is made from some mineral oxides, such as synthetic fats, kaolins, for example. And these are subjected to size reduction in order to remove some of the things that are embedded in this raw material for better molding and mixing. And following the main process is the size of screening. Screening is done as well in order to remove some of the unwanted materials and then the raw materials to get the desired material producing forming these ceramic products. Following the screening is the mixing of the raw material, that is the constituents of the ceramic material, the raw material, are combined by mixing. That is more creating more homogeneous products for use in the form of any measure of the ceramic products. And the mixing. Following the mixing is the following process. In short, the following process is in two categories: dry forming and wet forming. In wet forming, some microbial chocolate tables are used in shaping the ceramic body. this robotics, some equipment known as potter's wheel. Following the formation is a drying process. Generally, we remove water that is embedded in the forms.